This, of course, being from the days that we were allowed to make some sound with our cars. This car has the carbon ceramic brakes.
Inventory intake.
Black, black, black. Going to look real quick. 293.4. What's up, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to this POV review by Autotop.nl. My name is Max, and today we are driving this awesome 2018 Audi RS3 Saloon. It is a very, very cool little, well, I wanted to say hot hatch, sedan basically, saloon. It's quite a weird segment, but it is very cool to have this RS3 in there because it's nice and short and square and muscular. And it looks the part. I think this is the coolest looking RS3 you can buy. I think it's cooler than the hatchback. And today, well, I'm going to show you around it, show you all the cool stuff on this car because it is not stock. And then we'll take it for a drive towards the Autobahn for an Autobahn blast. But before we begin, don't forget to subscribe and hit the notification bell if you want to receive updates when we upload a new video. And check out jcbaarse.nl, which is the company we borrowed this car from. It is for sale over there. Check out the website if you're interested in this car. And well, it has some goodies, this one, because as you can see, we've got a nice spec, a gray car, but with all those nice silver accents, the old school S and RS car accents. Nowadays, they all have everything in black, but this is the OG RS trim. With that Quattro logo in there, very, very cool. RS3 badge, silver grille surround as well. And well, here we have the first of the goodies, because this car has the carbon ceramic brakes. Because this RS3 in 2017 and 2018 was available with ceramic brakes, carbon ceramic brakes, which is super awesome. And it's very cool to have like these supercar brakes on your RS3. You can actually see that it's from August 2018. And of course the Audi Sport wheels, 19-inch, and with some very nice Michelin Pilot Sport 4S rubber as well. As standard, this car comes on Pirelli P0s, but this is just a way better tire. So well done, Roy, for putting your car on these tires. And because this car has a performance package, these front tires are actually 255 and the rears are 235. So you get a wider tire at the front to counteract the effect of understeer. So your front end becomes a little bit more steady that way. Of course, we've got the silver mirrors as well. As I said, 235 rubber at the rear. The Audi Sport exhaust, which is quite loud. This, of course, being from the days that we were allowed to make some sound with our cars. And Audi, BMW, Mercedes were offering exhausts and optional exhausts on their car that we can't even imagine now, 2 years later, because now everything has to be filtered and is quiet and boring. All right, so of course we have done reviews of this generation Audi RS3 already, but this is why we decided to take this RS3 and make a review of it, because it has an Inventory intake, which is cool in itself, but it also has a remap. So it has 520 horsepower and 666 newton meters of torque. Stock 400 horsepower and 480 newton meters of torque. So that's quite a bump. And well, this is quite the pocket rocket. Very cool Inventory intake with that carbon on the RS engine cover as well, with that red. It's a cool looking engine bay. All right, so I guess that's it. As I said, I'm not going deep into the RS3. I'm just going to cover it briefly because we've done it so often already. Okay, so that is a good startup. As I said, the exhaust is absolutely ridiculous. So on the interior, we've got black, black, black with a little bit of carbon fiber and a little bit of red. Some cool RS seats as well. Rear space is actually not bad because this car is quite small actually, but rear leg room is not too bad if you ask me. But if you're a taller adult, you won't fit in that nicely here. Okay, so let's take it for a drive. I think we covered most of it, and the rest is just regular RS3 stuff. Like this steering wheel, it's nice with Alcantara, but you know, it's not really something to focus on today. We are in comfort mode right now. We're going to switch to dynamic mode, which means that everything firms up, the suspension as well, which is really noticeable. And of course, that exhaust opens up as well, which means you get some nice burbles and a great five-cylinder sound. Oh, there is just something about this engine. It's, to be honest, to be fair, it's also the only thing on this car that has any character whatsoever. But because it has so much, the entire car improves and becomes something to covet, something to want, which is just magical. It's just that engine that makes it so desirable. Of course, we've got quattro all-wheel drive, which means that we've got a Haldex system. It's not as aggressive and racy as some of the other four-wheel drive systems we have nowadays, like you get in a Ford Focus RS. But Audi did listen to some of the criticism that the Haldex systems were a bit too safe and a bit too understeer focused. So with this generation, they updated the software for the four-wheel drive system, which means that it sends more of the power to the rear when you are in dynamic mode, and you know, it looks at driver input as well. So if you want more aggressive driving, it will send more power to the rear. Little tunnel. Which meant, ooh, I just heard the Venturi. I don't know if you guys can hear that. It's not that loud, but if you release the throttle, you can hear, yeah, you can hear the blow-off valve, and it sounds really, really good. So the power is actually, it is quite insane, 520 horsepower in this little 1500 kilo car that feels really, really small. Whoa, picks up really, really well. That torque, 666, what a cool figure, and man, what a big figure. Alrighty, here we go. Here we go at the Autobahn. Let's see what we can do with this little pocket rocket. Close the roof. And here we go. Now stock, the RS3 is limited at 250 kilometers an hour. If you get the performance package, that goes to 280 kilometers an hour. Let's find out if JD Engineering, who tuned this car, have also removed the limiter. I actually can't see the speedo, so I'm going to look real quick. 293.4. 294 kilometers an hour. Not bad at all. That was actually quite quick. We got a tire pressure notification, but pressures are okay, so I don't know why it's giving that. But wow, it is actually seriously fast. And well, I'm acting surprised, but I obviously already knew that, because we measured it from 100 to 200 at 8.53 seconds, which is respectable, I would say. Yeah, it is one of the fastest, like, little hatchback. Well, I'm still calling it a hatchback, which it isn't, but it still falls in that same category. But it's actually really, really quick. This is just a one gear pull, fifth gear. That's quite serious. Okay, I just learned that the tire pressure notification has to do with the fact that this car is on Pilot Sport 4S tires instead of the P0s, and apparently the car doesn't recognize the tires or something like that, so nothing to worry about. tire pressures are a-okay. And right after this, BMW is done overtaking. She's going to stretch it a little further. Doesn't matter, we'll wait. Because I've seen a little gap ahead, I think... Oh, brake, yep. Here we go, full throttle. The tuning is actually pretty nice. It feels powerful, strong across the rev range. And it feels... Not only does it feel torquey, which is a word we regularly use, but I'm going to invent a new word, which is it feels turbo-y. I don't know if that's a word, but if it's not, I'm going to coin it, because it feels very turbo-y. You have a little bit of turbo lag, but once that lag is gone, you have that boost, and it just feels so powerful, combined with that five-cylinder sound. Is just a joy to drive, an absolute joy. It's getting hot in here. I'm going to turn on the AC. Way too die hard. So why do I feel this sedan version of the RS3 is the one to have? Well, I already said because I think it looks the coolest. But I also think that it's a little bit more serious. I think it's a little bit more grown up. And especially with a tune like this, 520 horsepower, and I mean, a top speed of 306 kilometers an hour on the speedo the owner has done. I'm getting close to that now actually, but we have to brake here because this is the border. With this tune, it is really next level. I mean, the 100 to 200 acceleration time is nearly the same as an Alfa Romeo Giulia Quadrifoglio. So that's a really serious performance car. It's also quite close to the new Audi RS6, which is both a testament to this car's power as well as the RS6's disappointing power. But it does make it more serious, and especially if you have a tune like this, the numbers are very serious as well, and it performs really, really well. And the term pocket rocket is just the only thing I can think of for this car. It is freaking awesome. As I said, it's for sale at JC Baarse, so go check out their website. You can check it out with a link in the top comment. For now, that's it for this review. I hope you enjoyed it. You can subscribe by clicking the big button right there. You can also check out this video or go check out this playlist. See you at the next one. Bye.